every brother that's caught in the crossfire. That's caught in the crossfire. What's up, guys? It's Phil and
Hayden.
And welcome back to episode 3 of Modernizing G.I. Joe. In today's episode, we have the 1987 vintage G.I. Joe, A Real American Hero, Persuader tank, and the JoeCon Back-Stop. Back-Stop came with the Battle Force 2000, and he was issued as a paratrooper for some reason. So I'm going to pop his bag open real quick, show his file card and his parachute that he came with. Unfortunately, they didn't re-release the Persuader, but it's okay because we have the vintage one here. It was one of the vehicles I had when I was a kid, and I played with it a lot, so mine got destroyed. And I just had to basically get a new one and restore it. So here's Backstop's file card. Real name, Robert A. Levine. From Montreal, Quebec. And here he comes with a parachute that I'm not going to unravel. But here's his little harness that he came with that I've already taken off of him, that the parachute will actually attach to. And I'll give you a closer look at Backstop. Here's a stand. He comes with a knuckled handled knife with some grooves in the blade, a little six shooter. Pistol on the side that does not come out. I originally thought this character's helmet came off, but I guess I was wrong because it doesn't. But still, you still have a modern Backstop here. Moving on to the Persuader. I picked him up on eBay. Pretty cheap. Got him for a few bucks. I won a bid. The only problem is I might have to get in here and put some stuff in the joints. The cannon doesn't like to stay up that well on its own. It will stay up if you raise it at an angle, but it doesn't go up all the way. Nothing broke on it. Tow hitch is here. All tabs are in place. I cleaned it up pretty good. Still has the original stickers on it, and they were fairly in good condition, so I decided to leave them. I also noticed a few of these grills on some I looked at had been broken off. But the only thing that this one didn't come with was the missiles. So I went ahead and found a seller selling the missiles separately, and I grabbed 6 that it needs, and I'll throw them on it in a second. But I want to show you that the Persuader did come with its blueprints. So here we have them here. These are the original 1987 blueprints. G.I. Joe Persuader. I remember when I got this was when I was a kid. I was pretty excited. I was like, what is that? Because I never saw it on the show. But it ended up just being a later vehicle that they didn't introduce in the show. I don't believe they did. Unless it was on the Series 2 that came. That was the Dick program. I know it's a rough name to say, but I think it may possibly have been on there. But I'm not positive, so don't hold me to that. Gotta be careful with these. I know these missiles tend to snap a bit if you put too much pressure on them. They are pretty brittle, so I'll carefully put them in place. And the stickers that go to the missiles are not on these missiles, but it's okay. I don't really need them. I just wanted to make sure this thing was fully complete. There's one side, so now we get side 2 of the missiles on. Now we'll go ahead and put Backstop in his driver's seat. So I'm just going to take his pistol and his knife and toss them in the back gunner cockpit. Lift up the cannon, move this gun aside, give him a little hose, and place him inside like so. He fits okay. So the only issue is the cannon here it can't go over top of his head unless you set it on his head, and we're not going to do that, so we're just going to kind of angle to the side a little bit. Now, to go with the box art, like you'll see right here. in the box art, he has a co-pilot or gunner, and that would be Jinx. So here I have the San Diego Comic-Con Jinx. I'm going to go ahead and remove her weapons and position her in the cannon, like so. Aim that down like it's ready to go. And beep, 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 beep. Actually, the box art's like this. So we'll go ahead and do that. And there we have it. The 1987 G.I. Joe Persuader with Backstop and Jinx. Cool. Alright, so moving on. I'm going to show you off a custom I was working on. He is not entirely finished, but it's okay. You'll get the idea once you see it. But what I did was I took a man-eating plant from the Adventure Team set, G.I. Joe Fan Club exclusive, and I took two different Cobra Commanders here. I got some parts here from a Boss Fight Studios figures. I gave him a regular human foot. I got the Boss Fight chest that I sculpted a ripped open, you know, uniform jacket out of molding clay. Gave it some paint. Did the same to the arm. The arm is also a Boss Fight Studio figure. This is a monster hand from Boss Fight that's not painted yet. Likewise with the right foot down here. I did do a little tweaking with the Dremel and drilled out some parts on his glove. Replaced his right hand with a Boss Fight figure. Gave him the Ultimate Cobra Commander head. I did darken the blue a bit on... I'm sorry, not darken. I did lighten the blue a bit on his suit, so I went over that carefully. He does have a little bit of rips on his leg, if you can see him here, that I did with the Dremel also, and just painted in to show the Cobra skin. And, yeah, this is going to be part of my Cobra Law customs I'm doing. I have a Globulus coming up, and I also have a female who's going to go into one of my dioramas, which I'm not going to reel too much on that yet. It's not Pythona, but it's going to be pretty neat. So yeah, that's going to do it for this episode of Modernizing G.I. Joe.
If you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to give a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the notification so you know.
Ding, ding, ding.
Make sure to follow us both on Instagram at Everything.gijoe.
Crossfire X Collectibles.
Make sure to check out our Patreon. It's only
$1. $1.
And check out our Facebook at HP.
Crossfire Collectibles.
We'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.
Peace.